Hi guys, so in this video we're going to cover how to make a simple webbing like this. I'll just show you in the render view, something like this, out of a simple sphere and using mechanics that we have already learned. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to throw all these onto its own layer. So go ahead and make sure that you have your project window all set up, and let's get started. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to come up to our poly modeling, and we're going to drop a sphere. What we're going to do is use the one half of the sphere to make our webbing. So I'm going to make sure that I am in the four panel view, either press the space bar to get in the four panel view, or go ahead over here and press that one that has the little four cubes. And we're going to go down and look down in the front or side view of our sphere. Go ahead and hit the right mouse button and go into face mode. And we're going to delete half of our sphere. And then what we're going to do, you could delete this last one too. Then go select them all, go into scale mode with R, and we're going to just squish this down so it's flat. So the difference between this is getting our webbing shape as to dropping down a plane of the circle that doesn't quite have the shape that we're looking for. But the sphere gives us this nice webbing shape here. So let's go ahead back into face mode, and we're going to select all of our faces now. With all of our faces selected, we now need to create these inner webbing bits. So we are going to do an extrude. We're going to make sure that we have keep faces together off. So that means when we extrude, all of them aren't acting as one. They are all now acting as separate pieces. And then we're going to press R and we will do hold down R and hold down the left button to switch it on over into component. So now when we scale in using this middle mouse, we will be scaling each one of these in individually. And go ahead and get these to how you like the look of it. Maybe you want these a little bit thicker, maybe you want the side a little bit thicker, or you want this really thin. Notice as it goes in, these do get a little bit thicker, so just watch that. Once you have that all to your liking, we're going to go ahead with all those faces still selected and press delete. If you had unselected them, go ahead and Z back to redo that, because it is very important, because now we have our webbing cage. So the next thing, if you look at a spider web, it brings in each one of these edges. First one I'm going to do is going to go to Edit, Delete by Type, History, Modify, Freeze Transformations, and then do another Modify and Center My Pivot so that it is now in the shape and not floating down where our sphere used to be. Next, what I'm going to do is cut through these edges to create a point in which I can bring them down. So let's go ahead and do that and hold down your right click and go into Edge Mode. Holding shift and right click, we're going to go into multi-cut, and we're going to focus on the top view. So go ahead and press space bar to get that view a little bit bigger and position your webbing so that we can see all the webs. Go ahead and hold down. If we cut through, we could be missing kind of that center. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up to these little magnets and I'm going to hit the one that has the point there. And that's going to snap it to points, or snap it to our vertices that's there in the middle. So now when I click out here and bring it in, it's going to snap directly to the middle. And now when I do all of my sides, it'll be going all the way through. Doesn't need to be perfect. Not all webs are perfect. Just go ahead and do all of those, making sure that we are not missing any dividers. What we're doing here is we're creating extra vertices that we can then bring in to create that swoop effect that you see in a cobweb. So go ahead and hold down your right click and now switch into vertex mode once you have those. Make sure that there is vertices along each one of our gaps. And we are going to Q to quit out of our tool, or go ahead and press the little arrow key so that we aren't cutting in more. And holding shift, we are now going to start selecting these all the way down. If you select ones that you don't want, go ahead and hold down the control to get into that deselect, and then we can just deselect those. I'm going to do those all separately in a second. So these ones are a little bit easier to grab as there's more space. Have to focus if you ever zoom out a little bit too far. Just go ahead and select these. Later on in class, I am going to be showing you how to make a fence. It's a little bit different in some way. You could also make this spiderweb this way. There is also another way with curves in which you could make a webbing if you wanted it more sporadic and more of a cobwebby way, and less of this traditional look of the spider web. New mouse that has buttons on the side, and while it's great for other things, I do not think it's great for Maya because I keep clicking the buttons and then it's changing smooth on and off. Which I've done that multiple times since I've gotten this mouse, so I think my next mouse will not. Now we gotta get in here and grab these ones. So if I was personally doing a close-up of this spiderweb, I might want to come in here in my face mode and bring those guys out a little bit because those are getting really small. It's not necessary if you don't want to. The reason why we do the surround select is one, it goes faster, and two, there could be vertices on the other side that you're missing. Alright, so once you have all of those selected, each one of the middle of our rows. We're going to go ahead and do an R. It was in component mode, so we need to switch this back over to object mode or world now that we have our pivot in the center. We're going to go ahead and hit R, hold down R, and hold down your left click and go into object mode. I'm going to come up here right now and just deselect my snap to vertices, as that can get a little messy as we go along. Up in your little magnets, just make sure that's turned off. And then once we have this and we have it in object mode, we can grab that center and bring them all in. So now it's kind of looking like a snowflake. What we're going to do is hit a smooth, and then that will make these more of a swoop. Let's go ahead and hit 3. And now you're kind of getting this cobwebby effect. Maybe I had mine brought in too much, but looks like I cannot. There we go. I'll bring those out a little bit. Maybe I'll do it in 3. Yeah, there we go. Okie dokie. You do have some faces that you might want to adjust in later, but I think it looks okay. If you have the spider web kind of off in the distance, then it's not really going to matter much. Alright, so now that you have your spider web, let's go ahead and stick it on something. I'm going to stick it on a wall, so I'm just going to create, or in the corner, like I have in my demonstration piece here. Go ahead and build whichever you want, but we're going to build this wall. For your assignment, you can stick it on wherever you need to. Of it. There we go. So taking 2 cubes, building kind of a wall shape, and then Control D to duplicate, E to rotate, holding down J before you press anything, rotate that to 90. I'm just going to move this over here and bring it out like so. Now I can go ahead and take my cobweb. Rotate this guy. Let's go ahead and change this to the world. Alright. I have to focus. So now we need to bring it so that it is, its little edges are touching the wall, and it's not so perfectly shaped. So let's go ahead and go into vertex mode by holding down your right click. And I could go and move these one at a time, but it kind of pulls here. So we're going to do a soft select, which is how you can get more organic looking items. So go ahead and press the B key. And you might have this all turn yellow. It might look like mine, where it has this kind of gradient. If we hold down the B key and then hold down your middle mouse button and move our mouse from left and right, we can grow this selection. So I'm going to grow it to about there, and then space barring so I can see my top mode. I'm going to start bringing our cobweb and in. And you may need to adjust that B again so that it gets to the movement that you need. We are just bringing these edges of this cobweb in and out, so that it gets a little bit distorted and looks more like a natural cobweb that you would see hanging on the wall. Again, readjusting your B. But still keeping it on so that we are getting a gradient to move. Since we get super dangled like in here. We can now start to place that cobweb where it might more look natural. I have it, and then we can start moving this in or out. So now going into object mode, we can more clearly see that cobweb. But these are both gray, so we're going to go ahead and click on our cobweb, and holding down the right key, we're going to go to assign a new material. We're going to just kind of give it a Lambert. Come over here to your attribute editor, and go all the way over, and get to your Lambert, and then we're just going to turn this white. So now we have a cobweb. I'm going to go ahead into this Arnold here up at the top, and I'm going to drop in some lights. We're just going to go ahead and drop in a physical sky for right now. And start playing with this a little bit. Go ahead and go back to Arnold and hit a open Arnold render view. Play. Can start to see our render come to life. With our render up, I'm now going to play around with these until I get the look that I want. You go. There is a simple cobweb using tools that we already know. So thanks. I hope you